leadership in the struggle to keep themselves free. That America has become the great bulwark of liberty in today's world is due in no small measure to its system of public education. Education has been a vital factor in the development. Port Elementary School in Eureka, with 325 pupils, was already overcrowded. But a local bond issue had been authorized the previous year for the construction of a new wing. All schools were equipped with modern furnishings and teaching materials, like those in the new Davenport addition. But even more important, District 140 had a staff of adequately paid teachers, well qualified for their jobs. When Stevie Riley moved into the second grade at Davenport, he found the companionship of other children his own age. A brighter, happier boy, he had all but forgotten the days when he sat alone and neglected in the first grade at Kruger. With new books and pleasant surroundings, Will Ann Sides and her sister Della May could do far better work than they did a year before in the inadequately equipped, poorly lighted one-room Harvey School. And now in the fourth grade at Goodfield, Marlia Gingrich found her work closely supervised by a teacher who could devote her entire time to a single class. In contrast to the dreary days at Holyoke, Marlia had gained a new interest in her schoolwork. But the benefits of consolidation have not been confined to the larger schools. Panther Creek, which had been kept open because of transportation difficulties, was reorganized to serve just five grades. And these were supplied with the same textbooks and received the same caliber of instruction available throughout the district. In addition, the children at Panther Creek were given the advantages of many special services made possible by consolidation. A newly hired registered nurse makes frequent rounds of all the schools in the district to check up on the health of the pupils. Most of the children in District 140 take advantage of the hot lunch offered every noon. A federal subsidy helps keep the cost down to 25 cents. In keeping with the policy of providing the most up-to-date methods of instruction, a program of visual education was set up. Both slide films and movies are proving an effective means of teaching such subjects as social science and geography. Any boy or girl with an interest in music is encouraged to learn to play an instrument as a member of the school band. But despite the progress made so far, the American people cannot afford to relax their efforts to improve their public schools, to lift even higher the standard of education for all the nation's youth. For the system of public education, which for over a century has played its vital part in keeping the